Now you can see it on the tennis eyes. Ooh, with a bat, as you can see from that magnificent shot. That is as good as any. There you see that West Indies second innings. Trotman the only man out in the fifth ball of the innings. Over before lunch. Caught Pollock at second slip with Watson. Greenidge on 30. Mattis 16. 51 for 1 and just 11 overs bowled. Now let's have a look then at the Trotman dismissal. Watson in his first over. And Pollock doesn't miss many, and you can see the delight as the Springboks go off to lunch. That was an early bonus.
Yeah, that was good bowling from Watson. He's got a new ball in his hand. It's important to pitch it up, especially if you do swing it. He does swing it, that ball swung, and Trotman's probably saying to himself back in the dressing room that he didn't really try and hit it. And as I say, these boys do like to hit the ball. Maybe he was thinking of lunch and he pushed it a little bit. But another good catch. Watch, he doesn't go right through with a shot. It's just a little push. And another good safe catch from Graham Pollock. That's three good catches he's caught in this test match. Here from the other end, see, it's just a push. Now you can see it on the television. He'll say, I should have left it alone, but it's not easy, I promise you.
So much depends on that man, Alvin Kalacharan. And he's out. Oh. Well, a bit of a Jonah I proved there for Alvin Kalacharan, just saying that so much depended on him for a West Indies victory, and I'd hardly said it. And Graham Pollock snatched up yet another catch in the slips, his fourth of the match, and he's taken them all so safely.
A little indiscretion here from Kelly. I was just thinking earlier, watch this. It's not quite there to drive. Here's a little drive at it, and the safe hands of Pollock does the rest. I was just thinking that if there's one man they want to get out, it's Kalacharan, because he is a seasoned pro. There it goes.
Magnificent shot there by Clive Rice. He picked that one up so early, beautifully in position. And Rice, having just put on 47 runs in 72 minutes with Curry, now knows that there's only Watson and Spook Hanley to stay with him and getting on after the bowling. Another attacking shot that just has the beating of the fielder coming round from third.
Those are two superb shots. He was completely in control of both of them. The shorter ball didn't bounce as much as Sylvester Clark would have liked it to, and he dispatched that for four, and then cutting that away just backward a square. That was cricket and test match batting at its best there.
Watson, who in Currie Cup cricket has made a number of 50s for Eastern Province, so he's no fool with a bat, as you can see from that magnificent shot. That is as good as anyone played all day.
I think Kenny Watson might want to put that in his little book of memories. He'll be delighted with the way that he played that shot.
It's Beanie. 8 over. Kenny Watson, he bowled like bowling. Actually, I couldn't play out Stevenson. I'm going to go now. Pinis bone la pola. It packatico pini no lens of the day. This team is no go. What's he got on a call skin by Yegalo Bola? Digital now call skin, call his eye bone. Put a man as a wee as bait is bola. Concentrating on truck and ride. Bam bam, they are packing. I heard a dark voice beside of me. And I look round in a state of fright.
Six overs have only cost 9 runs. He was right on target from the first ball, and he got the original breakthrough when he had Steve Smith LBW. Hearns will only get 1 for that. Terry Reid comes in from the extra cover boundary. Very defensive field for the big fast bowler from Eastern Province. Third man, extra cover, long off, long on the boundary, and a fine leg. So 5 men on the fence, 4 within the prescribed area of 30 meters, all looking after 1, 2 on the onside, 2 in the offside. Nobody in a close catching position other than the wicketkeeper. Nice looking shot from Yallop. They look for the second. Good fielding ensures that they don't get it. Well, that's what happens when you try and force the pace against a good delivery. I said at the start of this over that Yallop and Hearns would have to start forcing the pace. And that's exactly what Yellup would try to do there, going down the wicket to Kenny Watson, swinging across the line and paying the penalty. ...95 for 5. Holmes has 19, Rickson has 1. The important thing is that there are only 4 overs remaining. So suddenly that total of 230 that I thought might be the eventual target, that's looking quite a long way away. But have scored 9 runs and over, and that's no easy task against Watson and Van Vieren. But to describe the final 4 overs for you, well, certainly the remaining overs that we will get into our time before we go off the air for TV4, it's going to be Edwill van Aerden.
Telling dan 195 lopies for the verlies van 4 paaltjes na 46 balbeurten. There is op die oomblik a golf tempo van veracht alle praktische doelen is 4,3 per balbeurt. Kenny Watson begin de gang gestuur naar Skerby, waar Vlam Michou in gaten komt. Weer een goeie keer in de handen van zijn kapitein en paaltjewachter Richardson. Vlam met die rode haren, wat vooral opvallend is natuurlijk wanneer die zon schijnt. Met nog steeds Yellup. Watson had hem goed plaats. Bal aangeslaan. En alles veilig weer voor die loopie. Lekker tevreden is dan Watson. Hij die loopje gekregen om Van Vieren die bal werd te bezorgd. En fires, zoals ze bekend staan. Max scores op van Yellup. Daar trek hij weer die donkerte in. Hij scoort die grens. Zijn derde 6. Hij heeft hem goed bijgekomen. Derde man grens in die Colvers is durver nog een loopie. Dat betekent dat Kenny Watson slag biedt. En hier die bal zeil die donkerte in. En daar waar die lichten van die oorkant van die veld op die skaris kan, is hij tussen hulle een versierlijke 6. Hij is weer oor die grens, dus nog een 6. 4 ballen bleek oor, 10 lopies wordt gevraagd door die opie. En die thuiskare ken geen grenzen aan hulle uitbundigheid nie. En besef inslaps dat nog een nederlaag die Australiërs in die gezicht staat. Bietjie van die rand van die kolf afgeskil, maar wat maakt het eindelijk zaak? Hij scoort die grens voor een 6. En wie dorp so hou kritiseer als je die maximum aantal loopies krijgt van 1-0. Meningsverskil en kritiek veroorzaakt het. 7 loopies om te win. 1 bal bly oor. En na 21 loopies per beurt, nou ja, wie sal ons vergewe as ons tikster selfs in hierdie stadium in die opwinding geklop is. En kyk nou wat gebeur. 'N wykloper gewys deur die skeidsregter meneer Matthews. Dit beteken dat daar 1 bal oorbly, 5 loopies gevra word en dan kom Hughes en Smith en Yellup. Hulle kom praat met die skeidsregter en wys hom daarop dat die toereëls bepaal dat dat nie 'n wykloper kan wees as die bal, al is hy hoe ver buiten die bypen, net by die kolwer se bene verby is. En hierdie bal gaan tussen die kolf en die beenskutter deur. En volgens die toereëls geen sprake van 'n wykloper nie. Rickson gooi die paaltjie mis. En Hughes beduie nou aan die skeidsregter dat die reëls bepaal vir hierdie toer in die Australiese wedstryde dat as die bal binne 'n voet van die hakskene van die kolwer gebou word, dit nie 'n wykloper is nie. Daardie bal was inderdaad, hoewel ver buiten die bypen, net by die kolwer se beenskutte, tussen sy kolf en sy beenskutte deur, dit was dus geen wykloper nie. Die skeidsregter herroep sy beslissing. Die Oostelike provinsie eindig op 217 en dit is die Australiërs wat hierdie wedstryd wen met 5 lopies.